What's up, guys? So welcome back to the channel. So a little update. So I had a couple issues trying to update these videos to YouTube. When the whole
I made
uploading.
that ashtray for mom's keys only.
Okay, Chloe, calm down. Uploading wouldn't work. I kept getting an error on the screen after the upload was full, and I didn't know why. 3 days later, I did it again. I tried it again. Then after that, I went onto my channel, tried to look up to my video, and there it was, 3 days ago, already on the freaking channel. And kind of embarrassed that I didn't get any notification that it was there, so I don't know how that's gonna work. But anyway,
David can't leave our house without his keys. I better get them to him.
okay, I should have just started right here. So anyway, we're getting back to the video. This is where I left off. Nothing has changed, and now I can finally continue. We have the final episode coming up in like a few days, and I want to try to get this out as much as soon as possible so I can get right into the third episode with everyone else. So let's get back
Stat.
in. Window. All right, let's see what finally happens behind this door. Ah, there's David.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
I kind of saw that coming.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us.
Typical Chloe and David.
No,
Really?
Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your
She
age,
is.
I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Well, he's not wrong on that part. Granted.
My troop insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites
Did you
the
not
part.
hear me? I said I know what it does.
And go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this?
Isn't
Quality time?
that it right there?
Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something?
Eventually. Oh, sorry, spoiler. But I guess maybe he needs another attachment. One more photo.
This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache.
That's so sweet. I wish they actually made an actual photo. Camera, stereo.
Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore?
Is that the same one that Chloe gives to Max? One more toolbox. Should be. Oh, wait. Yeah, definitely the attachments.
50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
Okay, socket wrench, speak, socket wrench.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits? No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
I'm actually
alright.
It would probably be a good thing if Chloe and David would actually get together on a project like something like that. At least they're both interested in it. But we all know that will never happen. But wait, is that his car? Except the bombs leave him hanging. I'm gonna do a fist bump.
Fine.
I don't care.
Whatever.
That was so weak. But, so if that's his car, what's the car?
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
They have one.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Don't laugh at it. That's probably her dad.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk.
I want to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
Obviously.
You don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want
vacation.
To be real clear about.
Not like she had a choice. Her dad died. And now you're just walking right into it. Do you really think she's gonna change just because of that? Shut this down. Blue. What are you doing? Kinda wanna shut this down.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything he has to say. What's clear is fuck you.
Oh god.
Okay.
This is
language.
Going. A military language, French language, mustache.
Here.
Military language.
Let me put that in a language you'll understand. Foxtrot. Uniform.
Ha! You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Smart mouth. Let me dumb it down.
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry. What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Hey, watch your...
Watch your...
I can crap bigger than you, got it?
Crap, you're the crap master. I thought I smelled crap.
Oh, that's what I smell. A giant load of crap.
You... Your mother... You're breaking her heart.
Leave mama at the top. At least she has a heart.
All you have is... What's it called when you've got one porn stash and zero game?
I was in the army. You will respect me.
Well, I mean, respect me. You're not my father, Bill of Rights.
Doesn't the Constitution say no soldiers quartered in civilian homes without consent? Because for the record, I do not consent.
If you were a man,
it's
I'd...
It's cool.
A man?
If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you either.
Oh,
don't know why
snap.
I bother trying.
Mission accomplished.
Oh snap. She falls asleep, really. So it's like 6 in the morning right now, and then I haven't gotten any sleep at all. Okay, so we're driving to school. Something happens.
Country music?
Wait, what?
Dad loved this song.
Oh, she must be dreaming.
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. Burning the midnight oil again. What a beautiful day.
Mm-hmm. Purse.
This isn't right.
Oh god. Is this supposed to be a nightmare? Socket wrench. That's it? Okay.
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad.
Oh god.
Dad, turn it up.
know the music tab.
I get my lover from the grocery store.
Oh no. Oh shit. Motherfucker. Oh, that's definitely not good. Oh. They just had to play with our emotions. I already had to kill him once.
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Whatever, thanks. I do remember Joyce saying to thank.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady.
She was being sincere.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
You mean besides your surveillance? So we're back at Blackwell.
Hello, Black Hal.
Drugs. In 1910, future needs excellence. That's like they're putting on a play.
Hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face?
This is Elliot.
Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
Who exactly is talking shit about me?
You know, haters on social media.
Great. I wish I could tell everyone to just get a life.
So, how about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
Sounds awful. Are they talking about the... I guess maybe.
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
Nope.
All right.
He wasn't.
See you in camp.
Yeah, for sure.
Does that mean we get to see Warren?
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Oh yeah, that thing. Let's see. Oh, what? Steph. I am at the picnic table with Mikey. Thanks on the way. Skip. He's the security guard from this year.
Hey, Skip. Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today. Oof. Looks like you did, though.
Huh? Ah. Right. Whatever.
I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
That ass.
Yeah, you know how I roll.
Justin's mom, firewalk show.
So, I went to the mill last night. Caught firewalk live.
You went to the mill? Wait, you saw firewalk?
It was cool.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
Don't judge good music.
What? Like good music?
Preach it, sister.
That's
I'm in a band, actually.
No shit. Really?
We're called Pisshead? It's not a big deal or anything.
Pisshead.
I mean, I'm trying to get our demo out there, but it's hard.
Pisshead, huh?
Would you maybe want to hear it? Our demo, I mean.
Sure.
Yeah, okay.
Great.
Alright, I got the music down on low, so it's not copyrighted. Oh. I guess I can hear a little bit. Not bad. That kind of neat though.
So, what did you think?
Really good.
That was really good, man. If Pisshead came on the radio, I'd turn that shit up.
Oh, right on. Awesome, Chloe, thanks.
Why can't we have him as a security guard? Whatever happened to him? I remember Miss Grant. Yeah, how's it going?
Morning, Miss Grant.
Chloe, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today?
That sounds high probable. I don't want to ruin the mystery. I would hope she's going to be in her class.
I wouldn't miss it for all the manganese in the world, Miss Grant.
Your sincerity's overwhelming. With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad.
Well, obviously. But, so this must be when the Prescotts were finally taking over the school. So most of that money went towards the arts? Why? Why would they put it on maybe for Nathan's photography? Things will turn around, the arts will, things will turn around.
Maybe in another 6 months, a new donor will come along with money for, I don't know, more lasers.
Oh gosh.
More lasers?
Do we have any lasers?
Sadly, no.
That is sad.
I like Miss Grant. She's awesome. Alright. Okay, talk to him. Okay, so they must be at the patient table. Wait, what? Oh, this is Victoria! She's so much.
I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
She's so small, though. What happened?
Carrie Price!
Carrie?
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
Oh,
you don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Rachel Amber, Young Artist Award, Vortex Club.
Wow, the Young Artist Award.
Oh, it's not a big deal or anything. Like, 100 people submitted work, and my photography won.
Congrats, I guess.
So the Beacon's putting me up on the front page of the lifestyle section. Who cares?
And she's still a stuck-up bitch.
Wait, what about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
Tell what? We murdered a man.
Tell what, Victoria? It's a photo. Big deal.
But it's on Facebook! I mean, that basically means you and Rachel are like BFFs.
Not really.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging her or anything.
Is it drugs?
I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh.
Walk away, sabotage her. No. She may be a stuck-up bitch, but we're not gonna try sabotaging her homework.
Why would Rachel Amber ever hang out with Carrie Price?
It's Chloe.
Same old Victoria. At least she's somewhat better than later episodes. First game, she was nothing, and then she started out of the right at the end. So, who are you?
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha.
Samantha.
What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyt's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
It's funny, it's sad. I honestly never heard of the book, so. It's funny. I'll say it's sad.
The story is about how relationships only work if people are willing to lie to each other.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
I bet.
Okay. I wonder... That's her story. Okay, I can't talk to you, I'm just gonna go directly to the table. I don't actually have time to... Is that? Okay, I guess... Evan,
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record
Obviously.
High, and completely preventable.
Wildfire's an awesome play, doing this later.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model.
You and 50 other guys here.
What do you think?
I guess.
Awesome.
Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
Pyromania.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
I got it.
Oh, come on.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
There's a petition in the last game, and then there's a petition here. I don't know. I don't care. Anything to get out of class.
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
Do you want me to change my mind?
I... No.
How seriously am I taking this right now?
You're going to write down your name, Chloe.
There you go. Just don't expect this to become a habit. Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
Principal Dick. Big Mick. Big as she signed her name.
What? Caring about important issues?
Caring in general.
You want me to erase the name? Okay, so this must be Steph. Steph and Mikey.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
Are they doing a tabletop? Yeah.
You wouldn't understand.
Try me. I used to play. I don't know if she used to play. Try me.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Oh, God.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Why is anyone asking? Like,
you're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
They were just so happened to be at the same place, same time. And according to Chloe, they don't even know each other. So we're not friends, what's it to you?
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe,
oh boy.
You should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks,
neither
though.
Do I.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else
20
have we got
minutes?
To do before class?
Why not, I guess.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Why is that funny? I'm total elf
nice.
Barbarian.
I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know, I'm good. Alright, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone,
Black
you have fought your
well.
Way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you and greet. I am Elima, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
Chloe. Yeah, that's really original. Barb. Calamastia, I guess.
Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once made a man kebab. According to my character sheet, I'm gonna have to get really into this. I know how this stuff works.
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron. The Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns.
Durr dude.
The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground.
Durr
and
dude.
Surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie.
Yeah.
Where do you wish to go?
Okay, warlord tent? Obviously not. Prison camp, training ground. Training the ground to get new supplies and prison camp to gain more followers. So I guess prison camp.
Guess
first.
It's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Intimidate. Tempt with bread. Pick the lock. I don't think a barbarian can do that. Well, if they give me that option, I'm going
intimidate.
To intimidate.
That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
Oh,
you can try. What do you say? Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So
this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use-
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Dragon's a pussy, meat puppet.
I wiggle my hand. Hey, dragonkin guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do
obviously.
I.
The dragonkin pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
Could make you taller, could make you shorter, die of old age.
You're short, I say. But you can always get shorter. Give me the key, or I'll chop off your legs and beat you to death with them.
Good. Dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Oh my god, Chloe.
That was
very over the top.
I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Oh my
awesome.
God.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
Damn, Chloe. Hardcore. Training ground, get some
loot
supplies.
Sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
Damn,
you see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Fatal Cleave, Knee Slam, Pummel Strike. Fatal Cleave?
Okay, let's end this. Fatal Cleave!
You swing your great axe down on both hands.
Class.
The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun. Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game! It's going well. What about the loot? Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
Oh, come on. You'll pay for this for me.
Don't worry, Elamon guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamon? No, it's Calamastia, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
What's next?
More of those tents, all we got.
It's tent time. You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
Annihilation Strike, Brutal Punch, Wrathful Rush? Annihilation Strike?
Oh, holy shit! Annihilation Strike! That sounds boss as fuck!
One?
Oh god.
That's bad, right? Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
Oh my god. Damn. I am so sorry. This game is awesome. I'm so sorry.
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Character.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Isn't that
Durgaron
the point of the
approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp. Stomp. Stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
Dance, encourage Elamon, jump in front of Elamon, jump in front.
Alright, jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey.
Holy
I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I'm sure it did. Swing for his head, swing for his arm. Well, I have a chance to destroy the bracer then, if I just go for his arm, or can I actually kill him? I'm going for the arm.
I bring my axe down onto his arm, the one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant!
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Come on.
20!
Nat 20.
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop. Severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Oh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon.
Durgron is defeated.
This is intense.
But your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Oh. Maggie's got serious drawing skills.
Oh, wow. Pretty cool.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
Okay. Good luck. Is that?
What the hell?
And here we go.
What have you got here? Twitch?
Don't
Twitch.
Call me that!
True North.
Nathan.
A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott. It's not yours. Give it back! I hate that you're on the team now.
Okay, wait. So, at this time, Nathan was being bullied. Is it because his father, well, he said he'd on the team. Did he buy his way in or something? No. Or just because he bought the school and they bought the school and most of the money went to the arts. And, like, nothing for, like, the academics and the athletic part. Or maybe just weird.
You're such a loser.
Or maybe for his photography. They're both losers, take it somewhere else.
Want to take this elsewhere, guys?
He doesn't deserve speaks. This.
Whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
That's what I was right the first time.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Ethan, shut your mouth.
Dick
moves. Shut your mouth.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
So that's a bigger issue.
You know something, Prescott? I'm going to do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
I kind of want to see what's in the folder.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop! Chloe, do something! Don't just stand there watching!
Who are you again? Step in, stay out. I'm gonna step in.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Here we go. Idiot, back off, leave now. Idiot.
Idiot? You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
You should see him when he's in the future.
Congrats. You've actually got me feeling sorry for Arcadia Bay's most spoiled brat. That's how much of an asshole you're being right now.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
Crazy freak. I'm crazy, that's true. You know what's crazy?
What's crazy is that you haven't been held back yet. How is that possible?
You want a piece of this?
Piece? A piece of your bromance? No, a piece of cake. Piece? I'll take a piece of cake any day.
Please. Kicking your ass is going to be a piece of cake.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat!
You shut the fuck up!
Go Samantha.
Kind of funny when they sit, when they cuss.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you.
Had to be someone.
Take your pervy picture book.
Okay, I definitely want to look at him now.
Are you okay?
What is he taking?
You think I need help? From you?
Yeah,
you're welcome.
Are you alright? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Again, who are you?
Everything okay here?
Did you not just see what's
no
going
problem,
on?
No problem, Skip.
Skip. Like my dog Skip. You don't see a lot of names Skip around. Mom, oh boy. Glad we talked, me too. I know you're doing your best. Aww. Love you too, Mom. Tempest, all over the windows. Entrance, anti-drug poster.
Oh, good.
Rachel?
You're here.
Okay, and then Rachel appears out of nowhere and then drags us right into the school.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda. Indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues... Hath I listened to...
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome.
That outfit looks
this
awesome.
Is getting as surreal as last night.
A wink in there.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Wait.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most
Julia?
Humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective.
Okay.
The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Is this a third person answer? Miranda's an idiot. No, I'm calling it true love. Fuck
sometimes, it. When you meet someone who's going to change your life, you just know it, I guess. Also, you've got parents coming to see the show, right? At $20 a ticket, it's gotta be true love.
Wow. A romantic and a cynic. That actually kinda helps me. Thanks.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Huh. So this is Rachel.
Your eye looks fabulous. Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay. So... Why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah. Sure. Okay. Get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right?
So, is Mr. Jefferson here in the photography class? Flat. RA will suck as Prospera. BC. Victoria Chase, Rachel Amber. I guess maybe she would have gotten the part. Oh, okay, I see what's going on. Talent, is that what we got? Mr. K to cast you. Slut. Flat.
RA will suck as Prospera. If VC had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent? Is that what got Mr. K to cast you? Slut?
Guess they don't call it Drama Lab for nothing.
Tell me about it. Comment.
What to say?
Bitter much? Slut shaming.
Slut shaming is so 2009. VC should know.
Okay, I gotta give that one to you. Computer, props. Oh wait, something
Chloe!
About.
My pants get lonely without my belt.
Oh, here we go.
Rachel looks so happy here.
Oh, a younger version of it, Rachel. How sad. Why is the picture like that?
There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now.
Yep. Now let's see. And custom.
Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
Throw the belt over, bring it to her. Isn't she changing? But if I throw it over, is it gonna hit her in the head? Bring it to her! Oh, okay. Yep. Say nothing. That was a cool costume. Don't say nothing. You're gonna be a creep.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So?
Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
I'll owe you just this belt.
How about a belt instead? Perfect.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Almost done with this cup of coffee.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber.
Last night was amazing.
Giving attack was amazing. Firewalk was pretty good.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Maybe it doesn't. That's deep. Maybe it doesn't have to end.
Exactly. How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Fuck yes, has Rachel. Full Amber gone rogue. Am I gonna be going no matter what? I feel like it's gonna happen no matter what. Okay, it's in.
Fuck yes. I was born to ditch.
I hoped you'd say that.
Now about that eye. That is a hell of a battle scar. Do you want me to cover it up with some makeup?
No way, great idea.
Yes, please. People won't shut up about it.
Hold still.
This is a lot of makeup.
That's the price of valor. Close your eyes. Much better.
Holy shit.
Let's get the hell out of here.
This is gonna be one interesting episode. Alright guys, so I'm gonna have to stop it here, cause the longer I hold, hold out on the video, it's going to take a while to download, so I'm going to stop it here. Another reason why I don't like doing these type of videos of keeping it like about 30 or 40 minutes long is because like I'm worried that if I end up doing an end, getting to the end, it might only be like 5 minutes until the end, and just I don't want that to happen, so I'm being very precautious about this. So I'm going to be doing this episode here, and then I'm going to be starting the next episode right after this. I'm probably going to be starting it right after I'm done editing, because I don't feel like going back to sleep at all. So anyway, another shout out is for Katie Plays Stuff. She's an amazing person. She does the best she can with little that she has. And also, I watch her do the Let's Play for the first game, Life is Strange. And she had one of the most amazing reactions that I really liked about her. So anyway, don't forget to not like the video, and don't subscribe, and to just leave a comment down below, and let me know what your ideas are. Don't remember, no spoilers. I'm still trying to enjoy the game here. I'm pretty sure you guys have already finished, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.